Even if she go away. Even if she go away. Even if she go away. I'm a classic man. You can be mean when you look this clean. I'm a classic man. Calling on me like a young OG. I'm a classic man. Your knees get met by the street.
Okay, so I saw someone wanted more of this What If. So it's here. Pretty sure I ended the last part off with Goku beating Tien, which should be correct. So without further ado, let's get right back into it. Okay, so Piccolo Jr. would look at Goku. I think I said Piccolo Jr. As Goku would look back, Goku would charge up a one-handed Kamehameha that he's mastered over the time skip. As Piccolo would then dodge with ease. Goku would then jump right at Piccolo, punching him in the face. Piccolo didn't even see that coming. Oh, that was his power. Time skip. As Goku would start bagging on to Piccolo. Piccolo didn't think he would be this strong, as Piccolo would then push his hand out the way, kicking him in the stomach. He would then try to go behind Goku, as Goku would then hit a time skip, getting onto the ground, punching Piccolo, hitting him with the time skip Molotov. As Piccolo would then get beaten, Goku would charge up a Kamehameha, launching it at him. As the avoid Goku would then charge, Goku would continue hitting him with some time skip Molotovs. Even looking like he's running through some of them. Piccolo would be surprised with how many shots he's taking and that he can't even predict one of his movements. Not one! As Piccolo would then continue swinging in the air, Goku would say, "You're out of the ring." As you would see Goku with something in his hand, as he would then open his hand, throwing it in the air, as he would catch it with his other hand, punching Piccolo out the ring. Piccolo would then say that Goku needs to be disqualified right now. He was holding something. And the glow would still be in his hand. It would then start fading away. They would then try to look at Goku's hand as they would see nothing. Nothing's there. There's nothing that he's using to cheat. And that finishes up Dragon Ball. Oh, in this timeline, Goku would not get married. I repeat, not get married. So, Goku would grow up to become the world's second strong... No. Every universe's second strongest assassin. He would learn about the Super Saiyan legend. Now it's filled through rage. He doesn't know how he didn't get that rage when King Piccolo's little fatty killed Krillin, and how he didn't get the form. He would think back to all the times he had fun on Earth. Now he's just a universal killer, assassin. Maybe like his father, but wait. As memories would then start coming back to him about his real father and his mother, his head would start hurting as he would finally remember Bardock, Gine, Raditz. As he would then go to the Dragon Balls. He would find out Raditz has taken over Earth. Or, well, not taken over Earth. He would then find out that his father and his mother were killed by Frieza. Along with all the other people of his race. Upon finding this out, Goku would then ask, who is this Frieza person? As he would then find out who Frieza is. As they would then find out that's Goku the assassin, they would all beg for him to murder Frieza. Frieza has made them slaves. As they would then give him money to kill Frieza, he would get ready to murder the Universal Emperor. Since this is time of the Namek Saga, Goku would travel to Namek, finding out Frieza's taking out all the people there. The Namekians would see that Goku's a pure-hearted Saiyan, and Andes came to come kill Frieza and stop his terrorists. As Goku would then see Frieza's ship, he would speed off, promising that he would make this universe safe again. Frieza would send something on his scouter, as his scouter would then break. He would prepare to call the Ginyu Force, as the Ginyu Force would then start coming. Frieza would then power up to his final form, knowing that it's the legendary assassin Goku. Known across the universe as the strongest assassin, known across the multiverse as the second strongest assassin. Goku would then arrive, as Frieza would then be in his final form. You've come to kill me, finally! I shall kill you first, monkey. Goku would then get ready, prepared to fight, as he would charge at Frieza. Now, if you're wondering why Frieza knows about Dragon Balls, it would still be found out because Raditz would still go to the planet Earth to find his brother Goku. And although he doesn't find him, and he would get prepared to destroy the Earth, which every strongest person in the universe would come together to take him out. So, you know. Yes, sir. So, and a few people would die along, like Yamcha. So, sorry. So the Dragon Balls would be found out, which would then lead them to finding out about, which would then lead Vegeta to come, which would then lead to be found out that after he kills Piccolo, yeah. And I don't think they're gonna be getting revived anytime soon. So Earth is actually either one, been taken over by Vegeta and Nappa, two, Krillin could kill them by just throwing destructive discs everywhere, which I doubt that will be a good one. Like, I doubt that would happen. And three, they could call Goku or hit, but they didn't. So the world will be taken over by Vegeta, Nappa, and or Frieza. And so, yeah, as Vegeta would then walk out of Frieza's out of one of the pods, we would then see the legendary assassin Goku, and someone that looks like Frieza. As you would then say, your planet, Earth, has been taken over by me. And if you know a little bald guy, very small, a female that always kept talking about you, and more people like that, they're all dead. Is Goku a look at Vegeta? Who even are you? I'm Prince Vegeta, the Prince of all Saiyans.
but now also the king of the world. No. Krillin. Everyone. They're dead.
Is Goku would then start powering up.
They're dead. They're dead!
Finding out this twisted way of dying, Nappa would sense his scouter would then also break, as he would sense as he would then go outside, finding that Goku was transformed into the legendary Super Saiyan. Vegeta, Goku, and Nappa, and Vegeta are amazed at what Goku has just achieved. He would time skip behind them, charging up his strongest Kamehameha in his life, as he would then blasted Frieza. I mean, Vegeta, knocking him out the way. As he would then be saved by Nappa. As the three would then work together to take out the legendary Super Saiyan. Vegeta and Nappa would then switch sides there towards the end, trying to join Goku's side to take out Frieza. As they would then be acting like they're trying to kill Goku, but aiming their attacks at Frieza. Goku would catch on as he would then start aiming at Frieza. Then as he would then finish off Frieza with a powerful ki punch. As Vegeta and Nappa would be so happy, Goku would look at Vegeta. You think you're off the hook? As Goku would then power up even higher, charging up at Vegeta, punching Vegeta in the face, sending him flying. As he would then kick Nappa in the face. As he would then send Nappa flying towards Vegeta. As Vegeta would catch Nappa as he would fall over, since Nappa's pretty big. Goku would move on top of them. Kamehameha. In the air. Kamehameha. Ha. Vegeta and Nappa would then start trying to get up so that they won't get killed. As he would then blast through. As he would then pierce the mech. Not destroying, getting close to destroying it or anything. Just piercing it. I'll let you off the hook this time. Next time you're dead. Upon doing this, Goku would get his own crew with only him, Vegeta, and Nappa. But it would then grow after getting the Dragon Balls. He would then revive his parents, his Earth, and then he would go back to Earth, you know. And he would then eventually get his family on it, and yeah. Don't worry, the androids would still be coming due to Goku still destroying the Red Ribbon Army. They wouldn't be focused, but the only thing is, they wouldn't be focused on Goku. They would be focused on every warrior in on the planet. Who will be aiming for every Z fighter besides Gohan? No matter how much I would like to say it, Gohan is still out the story due to him not being born because Goku and Chi-Chi don't get together because he stays a solo Pringle. But they would be aiming for Trunks due to Trunks just coming to the world. Yeah. But the only thing I feel is that Goku would not get the heart virus. I think that Goku got the heart virus from Yardrat, which means I haven't read the manga before, but I'm pretty sure I'm not sure if Vegeta's got it yet, but I feel like Vegeta's going to get the heart virus. But it is what it is. But Goku would not get the heart virus, which means he would be able to handle Dr. Gero. And if you're wondering, why did Goku go? It's because Goku, the main man, he got hired to take out the androids. by the Z Fighters, so yeah. There was really not much to cover for the Frieza saga and the Android saga, so I feel like we'll be able to move on to Boo, maybe even going on to Super. So the androids would not... The androids would not be awakened. But at the same time, since they're not able to find Dr. Gerard's laboratory, where he kept the androids, they would not be able to find the androids. Now, y'all might be like, hey, this is good. This means they don't gotta fight the androids. You're wrong. And now, there's two cells on the lookout. And now that the androids aren't released, it's not gonna take him a long time to look for them, knowing that where Dr. Gerard's lab is. Now, I feel like the cell from this timeline would actually find the androids sooner, because he knows exactly where the laboratory is, like how to get there and stuff, you know. And as soon as he's born, he's able to become perfect. He eats his siblings, or whatever you want to say it is, and he would then become the perfect being. And now he can easily take out the Z Fighters with hands behind his back. Now, Cell happening and the Z Fighters finding out, Cell would give them one day only to train, to power up, to do whatever they need to beat him. As they would then start looking for something that they haven't used in a pretty long time. They would call Goku, and Goku would get ready. No. Before you start getting on my case, like, Cody, don't, because I'm correct. You're wrong. I spit the checks, and your girl calls me King Kong. I'm not spitting facts. I'm spitting on the track. I really don't get no checks. I'm cheap as get. But, man, I don't even know why I did that. But, like, before you get on me, Goku would have achieved Super Saiyan. You know what? I'm not even gonna say it. Y'all can just watch. So, your boy Cell Goodell, Bardock would go up first, due to him being the third strongest. Bardock would go. Bardock would destroy Cell. Just because Cell's going easy on him, as you would then realize he's not actually destroying Cell. Cell is just getting prepared to destroy him. As Cell would then say, you really think you can take on my perfect form? As Cell would then start powering up. As Bardock would remember, this Cell has all the data from all the Z Fighters. He doesn't know much about the Z Fighters, so he's not really gonna be able to know his moves. As your boy Cell would then freaking hit a whole time skip on this man. As he would then launch a destructive disc behind him during the time skip. As he would then hit him with a time skip Molotov. As soon as the Destructo gets close to his head, he would then turn the time skip off. As he would then stand there, waiting for Bardock to notice. As Goku, Vegeta, Nappa, and all the Z Fighters warn him, "Move!" As Bardock would then see it, "What can it do to me?" As he would then launch a rebellion spear at it, as it would slice through the rebellion spear. As he would then jump in the air, as he would then see it slice a whole mountain. As he would be surprised, saying that move is way too strong, and he would never let that hit him. But he would remember his son has time skip, so he could just time skip, let it hit him, and then Bardock would then realize what he just thought. As he would then start trying to move far away from Cell, even flying away. He doesn't want Cell to launch another one of those moves. "Oh, don't worry, Bardock. I won't." As he would then charge up a Kamehameha, launching it at him. As Bardock would then get ready, charging up a rebellion spear, he would then feel hits coming through his stomach. As he would then get attacked, as the rebellion spear would then start going crazy. Time skip Molotov. As Bardock would then get sent flying down, crashing into the ground. As Raditz, Nappa, and Vegeta would then look, as Goku would look at Bardock. He would then crouch down at Bardock, checking his pulse. He would then sense there's a small pulse. If they don't get him to the hospital quick, Bardock can die again. The Z Fighters would rush Bardock to a hospital. As Goku would then look at Bardock. At Cell. As he would then put his fists together. Oh, and Mr. Satan wouldn't be able to get a turn before Goku goes in, as Goku would then get ready, powering up to Super Saiyan. "Not one little tear for your father." As Goku would then say, "Assassins have to have no feelings, no purpose to what's going on. They can't care about no one except themselves and the person that hired them." Cell would then say, "Surprisingly, I couldn't save the best for last. Man, I would love to beat all of them to a bloody pulp. But looks like I'm going to have to take you out first, Goku. I really feel like when someone's equal with the other opponent, doesn't matter. They're going to end up with a draw or, as normal, one of them winning. But Goku, you're not equal to me. I'm stronger. As long as you know that, we can continue. That's funny. Because I'm sure I'm the one that's about to kill you." As Goku would then smirk, Goku would then rush towards Cell. What? It would be so fast to the point where Cell can't even see it. Can't even activate time skips or move past the punch. As he would then punch Goku, Cell. That was raw speed. Because if it was time skip, I would have been able to break through it on my own. As Goku would then start beating on Cell. As he looks calm and collected, but really inside he's angry. Cell's not able to activate time skip, and Goku doesn't do so either, knowing that time skip's useless. They both know that it is. Time skip is a move to get the edge on your opponent so that they're not able to even, so that they can't try anything. They can't fight back, and it's a move that you have to use to finish someone off. Well, yes, you can use it to just attack, like how Goku's been doing it this entire what if, but time skip is a move mostly for finishing someone off with one shot, or maybe just finishing someone off. It's more like in Xenoverse how time skip Molotov is to finish you off. It's not like how in Fighters you can just use it as an ultimate. In Xenoverse, you have to really know how to use the move to actually be able to hit it in your combo. I took too long to explain, and I bet you get it already. I'm just explaining it for the people that don't get it, that watch this what if. But that's besides the point. Goku would then start moving faster and faster. Cell would not know what this technique is, but he has a red aura surrounding him, and it increases his speed, his strength, and his agility, and his defense. But it decreases his technique, and Cell can definitely see this, how Goku's in pain the more he gets the red aura around him. As Goku would then say, "Taioken! Times 20! As he would then launch himself at Cell, punching Cell in the face. As he would then slide across the ground, he would then blast Cell. As he would then use the time skip, which Cell can't activate. As he would then charge up a Kamehameha, hitting Cell in the back. As Cell would feel the pain coming from Goku, he would then say, "I take it back, Goku. You're really strong." As Goku would say, "You think that's all I got? I've unlocked many new forms. Here's one that I can really, really talk about. Here's one that I can show my true strength. It's basically my base. You want me to power down?" As Cell would then feel like Goku was just taunting him, Cell would then look angry. "You." As Goku would then power down to his base, it would then power up to another form that looks like he's just in base form. As a twig would then pop out of Goku's hair in the front, he would then get ready to fight. As the Cell would look confused. "Are you taunting me?" He would launch himself at Cell. "You can always use that red aura." As he would then miss, Goku would hit him and kick him in the stomach, as he would then jump in the air, jumping over his head like what Vegeta did in the Buu Saga. Or, I guess the new Vegeta does. From Legends. As he would then jump over his head, pushing him back, Goku would charge up his strongest dragon fist in his life. The Z Fighters are wondering, what is this? As he would then think back to that technique that he used during the Piccolo Jr. saga. As he would punch Cell in the face. As Cell would then get sent flying out the ring. As Cell would then get angry, powering up to his form of Super Saiyan. "Hammer! Hammer! Ha!" Let's call that perfect Kamehameha. As Goku would charge up a Kamehameha, jumping in the air. As he would then slide down the Kamehameha, he would then power up to Super Saiyan, and then that red aura, which is so-called Kaioken. Ultimate Super Saiyan Kaioken Kamehameha! This form is now called the Ultimate Form, or Potential Unleash, if you would like to call it that. I call it Ultimate because Potential Unleash was basically on the mech, and it came first, so I like calling that Potential Unleash for more. As Cell was then look flabbergasted, he would then start trying to hold the blast. No! 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 As he would then use a bending Kamehameha, which is from Xenoverse 2. And he would then hit Goku. He would then start charging it at Goku. As Goku would hit Cell with it, the bending Kamehameha would then hit Goku in the back. As Goku would then say, "You really thought." As he would then be in front of him with a dragon's fist. He used Tien's technique, the multiplier, as he would then punch your boy Cell in the face, finishing Cell off, he would punch him in the stomach as he would spit out the androids, both of them, as he would then charge up another dragon fist, but it's called Dragon Flight, as he would then start beating on Cell, hitting him with uppercuts and lots of stuff. As Cell would then be laying outside the ring, Goku would then charge up a giant ki blast with everyone putting their hands in the air. He would then put it in Cell's mouth, saying, "Eat up." As he would then send it down, as it would then blow up inside a Cell. As Cell would then be defeated forever and ever and ever. Krillin would not marry Android 18. I feel like Goku would take a break on being an assassin, seeing that he's way too pure-hearted and that he has way too many emotions, and especially the fact that he would also be in pain from using Kaioken too much. And he would probably settle down with Android 18 becoming his girlfriend. If you don't like Android 18 becoming his girlfriend, comment it down below. I just feel like it would be rightful because Android 18 was kind of like heartless, you know, against Vegeta. So like, I feel like he would still have that attitude, and that would make Goku like her. So yeah. If you like this video, be sure to slap that like button. Remember, if you're wondering what this is, it's a card that I made. If you want me to bring out cards, you know, like Xenoverse type of card, I mean, not Xenoverse type of cards, it'll be like what if characters I have, or like OCs that I have, stuff like that. Be sure to slap that like button if you want to see stuff like that come out. If you want to see that come out, be sure to slap that like button. if you want it to be like, be able to order it. So like, I could try to make a website, you know what I mean? If y'all only like this video. So be sure to like this video, hit that noty so you can get notified of all my videos. And remember, Don't get a girl pregnant. If you do, make sure she's hot and that she's not a thought. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace. I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. As always, peace. Yeah.